Hi everyone, my name is Danny, and together with Tom, Nick and Sian, we are the Ulster String Quartet. We were thrilled to be invited to perform for you today, and we've prepared a selection of classical and pop music, some film scores and traditional melodies for you to enjoy. That, of course, was Moondance by Van Morrison. The next piece is a duet that's featured in an opera called Lakme, which premiered in 1883. Written by Delibes, this is a duet with soprano and mezzo-soprano, very famous, used in the British Airways adverts. You're bound to recognise it. This is Flower Duet.
Thank you.
The next song is a beautiful love song written by Billy Joel. It was featured in his 1977 album, The Stranger. This is a personal favourite of my wife, Rebecca, and she was very pleased when we added this to our repertoire. It is, of course, She's Always a Woman. Anyone who's seen the Pixar movie Up will never forget the remarkable opening sequence. It follows Carl and Ellie spanning the entirety of their journey through life together. Beautiful, funny, sad, and everything in between. This wonderful wordless montage was accompanied by Michael Giacchino's Academy Award-winning score, Married Life. Thank you. Amazingly, this next song was a debut single. Not that it stopped the lead guitarist trying to sabotage it because he thought it was too quiet. The guitar stab stayed in, and the rest is history. That guitarist was Johnny Greenwood. The band was Radiohead. And this is a personal favourite of mine whilst growing up, Creep. As we're approaching Burns Night, we thought this would be a nice addition to our programme for you today. This is a transcription of a favourite recording of mine, featuring the world-famous Black Dyke Brass Band and the fabulous Philip McCann, a soloist. My love is like a red, red rose. Being called Danny, I remember this being sung to me from a very early age. This is another transcription, this time from Percy Grainger's orchestral piece, Irish Tune from County Derry, or as it's more commonly known as, Danny Boy. Next up is a love song made famous by Elvis Presley when he recorded it for his 1961 album Blue Hawaii. This is Can't Help Falling in Love.
Thank you.
The music world lost an icon last year with the passing of composer Ennio Morricone. Amongst a wealth of compositional works, his film and TV music has graced our screens from the early 60s to as recently as 2016. Many of his works have been performed on the concert stage as standalone pieces, and this is probably the most famous one of them all. Featured in the film The Mission, this is Gabriel's Oboe. The next song was singer Etta James's signature tune, and with its passionate vocal and sweeping orchestration, it's as popular today as it was when it was released in 1960. This is At Last.
Thank you.
When it was released in 1939, MGM's The Wizard of Oz won two Academy Awards, including Best Original Song for our next piece, which became Judy Garland's signature song. More recently, it's become a source of comfort and hope, along with all the rainbows on show in windows around Northern Ireland. This is Somewhere Over the Rainbow. A few years back, we were invited to present an evening of film music with our friend Tim Burden here in the Black Box as part of the Belfast Film Festival. This next song was arranged specially for that night, and it's remained a favourite of ours ever since. It really is from the golden era of Hollywood, more specifically 1938, swashbuckling classic, The Adventures of Robin Hood. The sumptuous Academy Award-winning score was composed by Austrian-born composer Eric Korngold, and this is the love theme, Marion and Robin. Thank you. Pixar, as we briefly touched upon earlier, really are masters of their craft in creating movies for the whole family whilst evoking every emotion there is possible. This next song is a perfect example when the audience are drawn into the painful heartbreak that Jessie the cowgirl feels when her owner doesn't want to play with her anymore. Walt Disney once said, "For every laugh, there should be a tear, and for every tear, there should be a laugh." How right he was. This is the beautiful When She Loved Me. The next piece is one of the most popular and recognisable melodies ever written. Amongst other things, it's featured in soundtracks of several movies, most notably at the opening of Raging Bull. But the truth is, we might never have got to hear it. Pietro Mascagni wrote Cavalier Rusticana, his one-act opera, for a competition. But when the time came to submit it, his courage deserted him, and fearing failure, he locked it away in a drawer, where it might have stayed had his wife Lena not submitted it for him. It, of course, was unanimously voted as the winner, and when it was premiered in Rome in 1890, it received no less than 60 curtain calls. This piece is an orchestral interlude as part of that opera. This is Intermezzo. Thank you. We love our film music, so we couldn't not have any John Williams. This is a real favourite and is enjoyed at many an orchestral film night. This is our arrangement of the fabulous theme to Jurassic Park.
Thank you.
We've come to our last number, so we would like to send our heartfelt thanks to Sean, to Richard, and to all the Out to Lunch team, and to you at home for continuing to support the arts during these difficult times. Stay safe, stay well, and we hope that we'll be performing for you soon, in the flesh, like the good old days. We thought we'd finish with an upbeat, positive, feel-good song, so where better than to return back to Pixar, back to Toy Story, back to Randy Newman. This is You've Got a Friend in Me.